Mr. Al-Kubayban, allow me to come in there, right? You say that it's nonsense that it could have come from a higher up. It was clearly high enough for somebody to authorize 18 people coming to Istanbul, to authorize a reconnaissance mission, to authorize the consul general to smooth the path for all these people, to come in, to have a forensics expert, to have a double involved in misdirection and a possible cover-up afterwards. Somebody was high enough up to authorize all of this. So let me ask you my question again. How do you feel about this, given that there was premeditation and somebody, I didn't say Mohammed bin Salman, somebody important enough ordered other important people to do this ghastly act? How do you feel about that?
Now, of course, there is some instructions to do a continuous, interact with the consulate or, let's say, ambassadors or any other agencies work for the national security for the Saudis. So this is well known, and this is the duties of those kind of, intel agencies. Now, the orders from higher authorities, you knew, sir, and dear viewers understand that the king already took, a quite strong decisions by dismiss a couple of major players, in fact, more than two in the agency. And I'm sure that they will be transferred for investigations. Now, one more thing here, sir, let me clarify it. All medias, and including here in the TRTs, that they are trying to accuse, for any reason, the Crown Prince. You did not say it now, but this has been almost for the last, 20 days.
I'm sorry, this is a man in de facto control of your country. He takes all the credit when we talk about reform, when we talk of Vision 2030, when we talk about women driving. And now when a man goes into the consulate and ends up in pieces and dead, you don't want us to ask any questions?
Well, it's up to you, sir. No, ask. I am here to answer your questions, sir. But what I'm saying, yes, there is some instructions and maybe previously instructions to act within a proper way, within the legitimate rules, within what that cannot exceed to affect the relations between the two countries. Now, if we look at Mr. Khashoggi, God, Allah yarhamah, that he did not do that much effect to the Saudi's government. He was trying to show his opinion. So I don't see him a threat toward the Saudis. But as the Saudi story saying, or the official people saying, yes, there was a different talk from the beginning till almost a few days ago, and then the kingdom recognized it. And even though that what I'm saying is we are still under investigation. Okay.